Oh, hey, you're back. What are you doing here? Oh, you want to hear me make fun of this show again? Seriously? All right, if you say so. The first video essay that I made on this show was entirely dedicated to the magic within it. Nothing peeves me more than a magic system that is essentially just, you can do whatever the plot wants you to in this scene. Just have all the magic you want, it can do anything.
With new magic, you can do anything!
Unless your magic powers are inconvenient for the plot at that time, in which case you just gotta forget about your abilities for a second. Now, my first video essay on the magic was a little bit on the short side, and I guess I didn't really explain myself clearly enough. Based on some of the comments I got, some people got the impression that I think having overpowered things in your story is bad automatically. That's not true. You can have crazy OP shit in your story willy-nilly as long as you're able to write around it in ways that make sense. To go more in depth on what I mean by that, let's talk about something that I mentioned in my first video. The good old portal spell, the ability to stitch two points in space-time together by flicking your wrist. Based on the other spells we see used in this series, essentially all you need is a little bit of practice and you can just flick your wrist with a Terrasphere and create a portal to wherever you want. And we even see characters like Dretch create portals into the demon realm and across the lands casually. So these people have the ability to just casually create portals willy-nilly all over the place, and yet they decide, you know what, I'm just gonna take a boat down to the mission. The Triad can easily teleport, Dretch is shown using the portal spell, and if Caraway is even half a guardian, he should know how to use this portal spell as well. But despite that, they decide, we're just gonna take our time, you know, ride a boat while there's a dragon which is an active threat and is probably killing mermaids as we speak. So I have to fess up in my last video and say that I was kind of wrong. I made it seem like the fact that these portals could be used for super overpowered reasons was the problem, but it's not. The fact that nobody is using them is the issue. There are a ton of really insane things you can do with portals, and even some common sense things that anyone with half a brain could think of in 5 seconds flat. It doesn't take a super genius to realize that creating portals across the land is a lot faster than taking a boat. And before anyone hits me with the excuse that these characters are just teenagers, they wouldn't have common sense. Well, what about the Triad? What about Caraway? What about Dretch? What's their excuse? Are they going senile? Well, to be honest, the only way this makes sense is if the characters are complete morons. Well, maybe it was the writer's intention to make every single character a hapless idiot, but for some reason I doubt that. Now, when I bring stuff like this up, the typical excuse is that, well, other stories have OP things like this in it. And that is true, there are other stories that have portals and teleportation all over the place, so why don't we talk about one of those for a second? So let's think, what's a story that's widely recognized, has magic, and also has wizards who can create portals left and right whenever they want?
Tony Stark, I'm Dr. Stephen Strange. I need you to come with me.
That's right, the good old Marvel Cinematic Universe. You know, I never thought I would bring up the MCU as an example of magic done right, because that's kind of funny when you think about it. Now, I'm gonna be honest, the MCU has its own laundry list of problems when it comes to the magic within the universe. I'm not gonna go over its flaws here, because that's a whole other topic, but when it comes to magic, it's way better than High Guardian Spice. To illustrate this, I'm gonna show you a few clips from some Marvel movies, and I want you to tell me what you notice. And I'm probably gonna get copyright claimed for doing this, but I'm committed. Okay, so, notice anything crucial? Anything important that's within these scenes? Oh yeah, that's right! They're using the portals. Imagine that. Imagine actually using the magic that you have to your advantage. Characters that aren't brain-dead stupid and realize, holy shit, these portals are amazing, we should be using them all the time. Now that's the real magic right there. Imagine seeing characters actually using their powers right. Now, I want you to imagine that instead of having this scene here while all the characters teleport in, Doctor Strange in Endgame was just like, alright Peter, we need to get a spaceship, fly all the way back, and take forever to get everyone here. What's that? I have portals? Eh, fuck it, we don't need them. Do you notice how stupid that sounds? And in High Guardian Spice, this doesn't just apply to the portals either. There are a ton of spells in there that would be incredibly useful for day-to-day life that for some reason people decide not to use. At least in the MCU, when people have these OP magic abilities, they decide to actually use them whenever it makes sense. Or, well, most of the time. I know there's certain scenes in the MCU where magic users just act like complete idiots, but they're dumb there too, and they're especially dumb in High Guardian Spice. And yeah, it's a little weird that the Magic Sanctum has stairs when they primarily use portals to get around everywhere, but you know, you win some, you lose some. So how do characters in High Guardian Spice fight with magic? Well, they typically just use lasers. That's it, they just shoot lasers. They have access to all these insane spells. They can conjure fire, they can trap people inside bubbles, they can teleport, they can do all these insane things, and yet every single fight, all they do is just pew pew pew. Honestly, I think the only time magic was used in an interesting way in a fight was in the final episode when they were tag-teaming up against Mandrake. There they were flying around, redirecting things with force fields, using water to put out fire, stuff like that. So yeah, one fight out of the entire series. Good job, guys. Now, much like many things in High Guardian Spice, there tends to be a lack of creativity here. These writers somehow can't comprehend how useful any of these magic spells would be in combat situations, so all the characters just decide to use the same laser spell over and over again. It's a similar thing to Harry Potter, where the characters just spam out the same handful of spells willy-nilly. But at least the Harry Potter characters realize how OP some spells are compared to the rest and decide to use those in particular. Here, the characters have access to a ton of crazy OP spells and decide to use the laser spell out of all things. Although we've already established that characters can teleport objects without them being around or even being in line of sight, so just teleport someone's heart out. Unless you want to tell me that Allo is actually conjuring food in this scene, in which case world hunger's been solved, kitchens are no longer necessary, agriculture in general doesn't need to exist, and also the economy has probably permanently crashed. So you know, there's some bad to go with the good there. And I can already hear the two or so fans coming out of the woodwork and saying, listen, they didn't have the budget or the time or whatever to make this magic make sense. We couldn't focus on having these fights be cool or interesting because they just didn't have the resources. I still feel like that's kind of stupid, but I'm feeling generous today, so throw out whatever excuse you want. Budget, time, the fucking tooth fairy, I don't care. Let's just say they didn't have the resources to have any of this magic make sense. So in that case, why add it in the story to begin with? It's not like someone spilled coffee on their keyboard and suddenly portals were added to the story. No, it was a deliberate decision to add these spells into this. If they realized that they didn't have the resources to make this magic work, why would they add it in the first place? Just take it out. You're actively making your job harder by adding all of these overpowered magic spells. Now you have to spend time and effort writing around it in ways that make sense or finding creative ways to use it. If you don't think you're capable of handling that, then just don't add it into the story. I highly doubt the executives were coming down like, hey, listen, alright, we need portals in the story or else we can't sell this, so you better add the portals in or else you're fired. Now, I'm not an industry guy, but I highly doubt that's how it went down. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think portals are a necessity to get these shows made. So even if you want to throw out the good old-fashioned we just didn't have the budget excuse, it doesn't even work. That's what I notice a lot of the time when people defend the terrible things in this show. They bring up 100 excuses. Not good excuses, but, you know, excuses. Does it take a trillion-dollar budget and 400 years of hard work and effort just to have characters not act like utter morons in almost every situation? Is it me? Am I asking too much to have the characters' actions make any sort of sense when you think about it for more than 3 seconds flat? At least in a bunch of other shows, whenever characters act stupid for the sake of plot or there's a bunch of inconsistencies in the power system, there's usually a bunch of other great qualities that can distract from that. You know, like maybe a bunch of likable characters, an interesting storyline, or sometimes just even good animation. But since High Guardian Spice is lacking in everything, all of these problems are pushed to the surface. A lot of the time people will say, well, other shows have this problem, and yeah, there are shows that have similar problems to this one, but usually not this raw amount of them. Sure, in a vacuum, some of these problems might be small, but when you add small problem on top of small problem on top of big problem on top of bigger problem and a huge dodecahedron of bullshit, the entire show ends up turning into a huge mess. And also, problems like the magic system can leak into other problems, causing them to get even worse. The characters being inconsistent idiots is a problem on its own, but when you add the overpowered magic system on top of that, it makes them look even dumber. And again, as I said in the last video, magic is one of the core elements of this story. Almost every episode has magic, or some even revolve around magic entirely. So if you're spending this much time dedicated to the magic, and you have characters barely ever using it right, it looks stupid. We spend all this time focusing on the magic, but it still feels like we understand absolutely nothing. But you know, let's actually talk about more of the magic, why don't we? There's one scene in particular I've gotten multiple comments about. It happens in episode 3.
I want to master all the tools we have here.
Bitch, what? No the fuck you don't.
Some spheres grant eternal life. That's a bit much.
Some spheres can grant eternal life. The secrets of immortality are just inside of this, like, first year spell book. Please tell me those spheres are really hard to get, please, for fuck's sake. So this raises so many fucking questions. When it says eternal life, does it just mean you don't age, or does that mean you're literally immortal, like you can't be killed by physical weaponry? If it's the second one, why haven't the Triumvirate given people like Mandrake and Olive this ability? Because like they're super rich and have access to almost everything? Do they not trust them enough? Is it too dangerous? Well, we'll never know, because they never explain it. They have a habit of just dropping the most insane pieces of knowledge out of nowhere and then forgetting about it and never going in depth on how anything works. And the first excuse I've seen for this is that they were gonna explain it in season 2. Oh my god, you thought this show was gonna get a second season? Oh. Okay, that was a good one. Joking aside, they barely planned out this season. They were storyboarding shit before the first scripts were even finished. Are you honestly telling me they were planning to reveal all of this in a later season? No, what's more likely is they just threw it in without thinking and then forgot about it. I swear to God, if you can honestly look at me with a straight face and tell me that all of this was a part of some grand master plan for the second season that was gonna reveal all and solve all the story problems, at that point I would wonder if we even watched the same show. But let's just assume for the sake of argument that all these highly important things were being saved for another season. Well, we're never gonna get that season, are we? So why the hell would they think it's a good idea to add all of this shit into the story without the explanation coming until a season that may not even exist for all they know? I'm sure you guys can think of at least one video game, movie, or TV show that ended on a cliffhanger right before it got canceled, and since the authors were banking on having another season to explain all of these important problems away, it ends with the story never being resolved and it being extremely unsatisfying. Huh. I wonder what that sound effect was. Anyway, moving on. Hey, did you know that Rosemary's sword is enchanted? Specifically, the metal on the blade is entirely unbreakable. But not the hilt, though, because they realized, ah, shit, that broke in a previous episode and it was kind of important, so... Let's just say it's only the blade, because I guess hilts can't be enchanted for some reason? In fact, I'm pretty sure Flowering Thorn is the only enchanted weapon we see, unless you think Terra Spheres count. Maybe Mandrake's little fire blades would count as being enchanted? But that raises the question, why aren't all the weapons enchanted? Imagine how cool it would be if all the warriors had unique weapons that had different enchantments with different superpowers. Oh wait, I'm describing every anime in existence? So like, why didn't they steal that one? This show is already as bland and stock as it can be when it comes to the storyline, so might as well go all the way if we're ripping off anime. Seriously, one of the main things that 99% of these shows with magical warriors in a high school have, the enchanted weapons with superpowers they decide not to use, because I guess that would be too interesting. Or maybe it wasn't in the budget. I think one of the first questions that comes up whenever something magical is introduced into a story is why isn't everyone using this? In a lot of the cases, they come up with some reasons why not everyone can use it, like maybe it's tied to your bloodline or something like that. But here, since nothing is ever explained, we just don't know. 99% of the things that are magical in the show, we just don't know anything about, so we're just left with hundreds upon hundreds of unanswered questions that are never gonna get resolved. Now, I'm not asking for everything in existence to be explained down to the last detail, but could you at least give us something whenever you throw in these super overpowered magic things? Like, would it really be that hard for them to throw in some line of dialogue about how, oh, it's a super rare metal or something, just anything? It would take like 2 seconds. You don't need to tell me everything, you just need to tell me enough so that I can understand. If you're not gonna go in depth on how it works, or you just don't care how it works, then that's fine, but don't draw my attention to it. There are several times where they draw special attention to certain aspects of the magic system only to never explain it or never bring it up again. If you don't care enough about something to have it be in any way important to the story, or serve any purpose at all, or even be explained to the slightest degree, why are you wasting our time? The portals are actually a great example of this. It's one of the first things we ever see a Terrasphere do, one of the earliest spells in the series. They draw special attentions to these portals, show them off, and then the characters barely ever use them. They introduce the magic system with this very powerful ability that's extremely useful, and then the characters just never use it. I think another example that perfectly illustrates what I'm talking about is the Infinite Hallway.
Stop! That's the Infinite Hallway.
Yes, there's just a magical infinite hallway smack bang right in the middle of the school. Where did it come from? What's its purpose? Who knows? They take time out of this episode to have the characters over-focus on this infinite hallway and talk about this infinite hallway, and it never comes back again. At first when they showed this, I thought it was a setup for when it might come back later, like maybe Sage gets lost in the infinite hallway and they have to find her, or maybe in the final episode they trick Mandrake into going in the infinite hallway and trap him there or something. But no, they show it off, have the characters learn about it, just for it to never be important or relevant in any way. They give us all these setups, but they never have the payoff in any way, shape, or form. So whenever we learn aspects about the world or the magic system, it's all irrelevant because, you know, it's never gonna matter. What's the point of introducing us to all of these things if you're just never gonna bother to use them? Alright, this show is pissing me off now, so let's get nitpicky. Did you know that time takes enchanted archery?
I was just telling Sage how you chose enchanted marksmanship for everything hours.
Yeah, but I'm on my way to archery. First lesson is how to take pride in your weapons.
That sounds cool. How many magical arrows does Time use? One.
No, these arrows are tipped with napping potion.
Spiked arrows, wow. That would have been useful in the fight against Mandrake. It's funny how when she's fighting Nepicat, she suddenly has these magical sleep arrows, but whenever Mandrake hits the battlefield, her arsenal suddenly changes. It's almost like her power set is being dictated by whatever the plot needs it to be in that scene.
Really makes you think.
Again, we're running into some of the same problems. They go out of their way to point out how she's taking enchanted marksmanship as a class. This time, they even show her using arrows tipped with magical potions, which is pretty smart. However, after this episode, she never uses magic arrows again. She just uses the normal ones. Again, why waste our time pointing this out, showing a character has a specific ability that they're trying to learn, only to never have them use it? Using arrows tipped with magical potions is incredibly cool. We established in the previous episode that potions do exist, and they're very useful. We see Sage use a potion to cure an entire class, and the potions teacher uses her potion to mutate and poison the entire class. As stupid as that whole scene was, it does set up for this scene with Time and her arrows, because it makes perfect sense for an archer to want to tip their arrows with some of these magical potions. So yeah, it makes Time look intelligent and cunning, it's really cool, why do they throw it away immediately? Every time they're on the cusp of doing something even slightly interesting, they just toss it to the side. They had potential for something cool and fun, but they just threw it in the garbage bin. Make whatever jokes you want about the transition magic, but at least that comes up more than once and it's actually a part of someone's storyline. Why couldn't other magical aspects of this world get the same treatment? Because it wasn't in the budget, I guess. The whole tipped arrow thing is pissing me off because it shows us that they have potential to do interesting and cool stuff, but they're just deciding not to? Every time, every damn time, this show gets my hopes up that it's gonna do something interesting for once, then it just bitch slaps me back into reality. But yeah, to summarize, the magical elements of this show are poorly handled at best. It's the exact opposite of what you want to do if you're trying to get an audience invested in your magic system. The important stuff is under-focused on, the unimportant stuff is over-focused on, and nothing makes any sense. The magic in this show is about as stupid and unexplained as the school it's taught in. And I swear, on the righteous name of Parnell, if I see one more goddamn comment comparing High Guardian Academy to Hogwarts, I will portal spell to your house and shove my Terrasphere up your ass!